Friends, this is Adik. Today demo I am going to show you how to communicate with the activemq using the SL. The SL is configured and on the way to communicate a secure level communication with the activemq in the mule application. I'll show you the steps which I have performed to generate the certificates trust store, so I can configure on the broker, the server, and the client, that mule ESB application. Okay, so these steps I have performed here. I have generated the server key store file, that is, and exported the key store file and the file, and generated the trust store. Okay, create the client key, then created the client key store, and then exported the client key store on the file, and generated the server trust store and client trust store both, and then copied the server, the exported file, the key store exported file in the client to the server, and server exported file to the client. Okay, so I'll show you the what I have done actually, so it will be more easy to understand. I have created the server file and the client file. So you can see this is the client and this is the activemq configuration. So what I have done, I have created the server cert file. This is in this I have exported the key store. Okay, and here you can see that this is the client certificates where I have exported the client key store. Okay, and the client key store client certificate file I have copied to the in the server, and the server exported a certificate file I have copied in the client. So by that way they can understand the both are authorized user or requester from both side. Okay, so this is the one configuration, and the second thing is that the configuration thing what I have copied in the activemq conf folder. Okay, so all this these files I have copied in the activemq conf folder. Okay, now I'll go to the application. Is there a simple application to send request to activemq in the queue? Okay, so just accepting the post request, converting in the string and sending to JMS. What JMS configuration I have done, I'll show you here. In the JMS connector, this is the queue I have configured as the queue. In the JMS connector, the default password I have used for the JMS here, for activemq, sorry. And then I have configured the rest of the property here. Okay, you can see here. Okay, there is no change I have done over here. Fine. So now you can see that what the references I have done. You can see that advance, and you can go. This is the connection factory reference I have made here. You go over there, I'll show you what the configuration has been done. Let me show from file, it's not being open. So this is the bean I have configured over here. Okay, and in the bean configurations you can see, let me remove the unused content here so it will be more understandable. So what the configuration I have done. Okay, I have created the a spring bean. Okay, with the help of that I have I have referred some properties in the file. in the bean. First is like broker URL. Okay, this is the SSL URL from the JMS. How it has been configured in JMS, I'll show you the example here. Okay, you can see, you can go, there's a in the you can see here, this is the Apache activemq 5.0.conf and the activemq.xml file. Okay, in that file I have opened one more another character. This is the name is SSL, and this is the URL to send a request to the SSL. Fine. And this SSL is referring the certificates as well. So I have configured the SSL context here. Okay, the SSL context is that activemq base, that is the activemq base directory, and the conf, and the activemq server case. I'll show you here the file which I have created in the first step. You can see activemq server case, activemq server case. Okay, this is the file mq-server.ts. You can see this is, and this files I have copied. So this file I have copied from the client, so that the server can understand this, the authorized client is sending request. Okay, so I show you that how to configure just this URL, make and configure the SSL context here, and copy the client exported case file in the server. Okay, so this is the configuration, and now go to the JMS component. This is the broker URL where we have to send the request. This is a keystore property. I'll show you the where I have configured this one. Keystore-file. Okay, this is trustor-file, and then their password. Fine. I'm now using the delivery attempt. So this is the JMS connector, right? What I have shown JMS connector, and they are referring JMS secure connection factory, right? This one, you can see. And this JMS connector is being referred into the JMS outbound endpoint. You can see here, right? This is the referred. So by this way, I am showing you by this way we are able to configure in the request, then add, this is the secured SSL layer communication with the application mule application and activemq queues. Okay, this is the one thing. This component is sending request to the third party. Okay, is the activemq. Second one is that this one is listening the request. The same configuration is the exact same what we have configured in the last in the JMS connector. Okay, JMS activemq connector, that what configuration I have done. I have created the bean. I have passed some request parameters, keystore file, trustor file, password. Okay, all I have done here, and let me remove this one. Okay, and this is the file where we have initialized all the values of the what the parameter has been referred over here. Okay, I'll show you this file name, configure. This is the file. Okay, activemq client ks, and this is the file. This is the trustor file. Okay, it's a very simple. That you have created this, the files trustor and keystore, and the exported file over here, and referred in the activemq using the SSL context, and open one another connector in the activemq. Okay, and refer as well here the client keystore and trustor file in with the help of the spring bean, and we have referred the spring bean in JMS activemq connector over here, and JMS activemq connector we have referred in the JMX outbound endpoint. Okay, so let's start. I'll show you a second another thing. I'll show you as I have started the I'll stop the activemq again. Let me show you the I'm sorry, I'm starting directly here. So I'll start the ActiveMQ. Okay, I want to show one thing, one the connector which I have configured over here. This is SL connector. You can see multiple connector over here, that is where we configure in the ActiveMQ, in the ActiveMQ in the configurations. Okay, this is the open wire SL ActiveMQ. All this has been there, is here, and it will open. It will the communicate the this interface will open, or connector will be available to send request and receive request to them. So I have started. You can see that SL, the connector SL started. So it's ready to accept out my request and response, and share my response. Okay, I'll go here. Okay, now is to no request and no response, no consumed. Okay, so let me start the application over here. Two application. This is the sender, other is the receiver. Both application being started. Let's see, it's successfully deployed. It deployed both. Okay, this is sender and this is the receiver. Okay, so let's see how it works. I am going to send a request here itself. Let me minimize that so you can understand that the logs over here. So this is the sender and this is the receiver, right? This is the sender and this is the receiver, right? So I'm cleaning this log here. I'm going to send a request from here. Okay, hello, welcome to person. Fine, this okay. So let's go and make a request. So this is the listener, this is sender. Okay, this is message has been sent, and see, hello and welcome to Kelton Tech Solution, right? This is the listener itself, this is listening. And this is the server, this is the application which is sending request to the secure application. It's fine. So you got my point, how to configure, how to send request and in the secure queue, ActiveMQ, RabbitMQ, or any queue broker application, is like broker server, like you can say RabbitMQ or TIBCO. You just have to configure the parameters which is required to send to the in the request. Okay, thanks for watching, and you can find my all these both the codes, both the application receiver and sender receiver, both code in my GitHub repository with the same name, except SL JMS ActiveMQ SL. Fine, thanks for watching. Thank you.